wrote some plays, and I am abashed to say I've never seen them.
Okay.
What were they?
Well, my plays, plays and operas. I just wrote the libretti for the operas. The composers did the music, of course, but the first play I had produced was Whylah Falls, the play, based on my award-winning book of poetry, Whylah Falls, which is a verse novel about love and death in a black community, very much like those I was a social worker in.
Why did you choose the form? Why did you switch from poetry to narrative theater?
I was approached by a theater company in Halifax to turn the book into a play. And Wendy Lill was essentially their resident playwright. Wendy gave me some advice on and was a reader, not a dramaturge, but she was a reader for the script as it was developed. So I think that she acted as a kind of editor, gave advice on things.
This is Eastern Front?
Eastern Front Theater, thank you, yeah. So they did it in 1997, and it was a smash success. Big hit, play of the year, 1997, for the theater critic for the Daily News in Halifax. And it later got produced again in Halifax by Eastern Front, and then they took the play to the National Arts Center. That was in 2000, and scenes from it have been done, but not the whole play since.
And did you take the poems and put them in a different form, or did you actually write dialogue and poetry?
It was dialogue and poetry.
And what was that like to move from poetry to dialogue?
Interesting and good, because it meant I had to pay a lot of attention to language once again. I mean, one of the things I did in working on Whylah Falls, the play, was just write reams of dialogue. I just write just dialogue, without any particular purpose, but just to get into the idea of the point counterpoint. Of dialogue. I understand that dialogue is always about somebody or some group of people having something at stake. Every conversation, somebody wants to get something from somebody else. And so there's always an implicit tension in any conversation. And so dialogue was a way for me to try to understand that. And also to work with the different levels of English. I shouldn't say levels, because that's like suggests a hierarchy, but the different kinds of English that I have at my disposal. So the more slangy, down home, up home, Africadian, to use my word, Africadian dialect, of course, standard English, and poetic diction, and journalism. So I worked in journalism. I was a student newspaper editor, and I started my own newspaper in Halifax. An 8-page monthly, and broke national news stories in my little 8-page paper. Came out once a month, 7,000 circulation. One page of the 8 pages, one page was dedicated to poetry. No ads on that page. And here it was, a monthly paper, and I still broke stories that the major press in Halifax could not get hold of. Could not get hold of, because I had community contacts, could tell me stuff that they would not tell the regular reporters, and so on. And as a result of that, I got hired to teach, or sorry, not to teach, but to work for Howard McCurdy, who was Member of Parliament for Windsor-Walkerville in 1987, NDP Member of Parliament. He called me up. He heard about my little paper. He called me up and said, would you think about coming and work for me? And I thought, it didn't take me long to say yes, because with the paper, I was making $12,000 a year with the paper. And he said, I can only afford to pay you $24,000. And I thought, well, you know, I guess it's a sacrifice I can make. I was on the train a couple weeks later and sitting in Ottawa in his office being his press person.